Hi, my name is Katie Ziskind. I own Wisdom Within Counseling in Niantic, Connecticut. You can learn more about working with us at wisdomwithinct.com. This video is all about eating disorders. Eating disorders are one of our specialties at Wisdom Within Counseling. We work with adolescents, teenagers, adults, and couples that struggle with disordered eating. Some signs that your loved one has an eating disorder are that they have extreme reactions around mealtimes. Your teenager, for instance, might avoid eating with your family or have very limited food choices that they allow themselves to eat. Your adolescent may be labeling certain foods as good or bad or having a hard time physically eating an appropriate amount of a certain food. So for instance, if your teenager is going to have cereal, they will either take a very small amount or a very large amount. Or if your teenager has anorexia, they might be even measuring or counting the little pieces of cereal that they permit themselves to have. So they might be measuring their milk and only permitting themselves to have a certain amount of a certain food. Your teenager may also have certain fears around eating certain foods. So a fear of fat, a fear of meat, a fear of bread, a fear of all these things that they are culturally taught are either good or bad. And so we start to kind of break through those cultural stigmas and promote intuitive eating and health at every size. So it's important to know that just because your teenager doesn't look underweight, they might still have an eating disorder. Teenagers that look underweight and are visibly underweight often have what we call as anorexia. Teenagers with anorexia might be already very athletic, and so they are exercising in excess, so too much exercising. Exercising for more than 1 hour a day, exercising more than one time a day, or running long runs that are really damaging and actually burning too many calories. So in addition to anorexia, we often work with compulsive exercising and OCD-like behaviors. We work with adolescents that might have guilt and shame around eating. So if your adolescent puts food in their mouth, they immediately spit it out because they feel guilt and shame about eating. If your teenager is really struggling with binge eating, so eating a very large amount of food in one sitting and then possibly even going to the restroom right after and throwing it up, that would be a binge purge cycle. And we specialize with teens that struggle with binge eating as well. And these are very important behaviors to identify sooner than later, because anorexia is a life-threatening illness as well as eating disorders. They can cause stomach problems, esophagus problems, skin problems, hair problems, and a lot of times teens with eating disorders also have other things going on. There might be a parent's divorce, there might be trauma in the past, sexual trauma. As well, a teen with an eating disorder may be coming out as gay, bisexual, transgender, non-binary, and having gender and sexuality exploration going on as well. Teenagers that have eating disorders may also be self-harming or cutting their skin. That's where a teenager will take anything from a car key to a broken light bulb to a razor and physically harm their body to create a sense of euphoria. It's a negative coping strategy. So oftentimes we see layered negative behaviors and impulsive behaviors that are causing self-injury. So an eating disorder is a form of self-injury. Cutting is a form of self-injury. Teen drinking, teen drug use, marijuana and alcohol use. Social withdrawal is very common, and teen depression is really common with eating disorders. So a teen might get stuck on a fad diet and feel like they have to look a certain way or be a certain weight in order to be acceptable by society. And really what's happening is the teen does not know how to love themselves. So we teach teenagers with eating disorders and disordered eating habits how to love and accept themselves just the way they are and let go of cultural shame around looking a certain way or having to be thin or having to have perfect abs. And we start to educate teenagers on how that's completely unrealistic and the movies and media just do a disservice to our body and loving our body. So we teach body positivity, intuitive eating skills, and overall lifelong healthy coping strategies to move in a more positive, self-nurturing, truly healthy direction rooted in mind-body-spirit connection. So with adolescents and teenagers that struggle with eating disorders, fad diets, body image issues, bulimia, and the intense emotions around it, we offer creative therapies to bring back that playfulness and to teach a teenager that you don't have to take life so seriously or yourself so seriously, and can take some of that internalized pressure to be perfect off of themselves. So we offer art therapies, yoga, meditation and mindfulness, outdoor walking therapies, when appropriate. You know, we can sit outside in the sunshine, or, you know, when appropriate, going for a slow, gentle walk to be in nature. But the creative therapies are wonderful for teens that have eating disorders, because those are skills, positive, holistic skills to help them love and accept themselves and really believe in themselves again and start to separate from that disordered eating voice. As well, we also work with parents and siblings that have a loved one who has an eating disorder. Whether your teen's in the hospital or coming out of the hospital, we would love to help. So you can book a free phone consult to work with one of our eating disorder specialists to help your adolescent or teen really love and accept themselves and have intuitive eating skills for the rest of their life, for college years and beyond. You can book a phone consult at wisdomwithinct.com. That's wisdomwithinct.com. We would love to help your teen thrive. Hope you have a great day. I'm Katie at Wisdom Within Counseling.